What? What up, Cadillac?
What's up? How are
what
you?
What up, what up, what Hi. Up? So just a few questions.
I had a razor blade in my mouth when I started the battle that I brought with me. Yeah, there's nothing left to hold but the cold as I breathe. No women, no popping, no dipping, no money, no steez. I'll be the I wanted to give it to Dre Vicious.
Okay.
So I gave it to Dre Vicious. But I won't. Shit, cut myself right in front of the battle. There's nothing that nobody can do to me that I haven't done to myself. You know, what people don't know about me was like I'm actually lived in the street for years. Mm-hmm. You know, I've been beaten, stabbed, fucking left to die in an alley, all of that. You know, I've seen people get killed right next to me. I've robbed dead bodies, you know. Mm-hmm. So what can anybody do to me that I haven't already done to myself?
Yeah, it's like, what is
you're gonna say something about me that hurts my feelings? Like, oh, like I hurt my own feelings.
Okay. Speaking of feelings, your battle was extremely, it was racial.
Was his not?
But that's not what I'm getting at.
Okay, what are you
But what I'm getting at is, this is just a question. It might come off as something different than what it is, but my question is, if you are that talented at lyricism and bars, are racial jabs necessary?
There's a double standard that exists within the battle rap community, and that is that anybody can say whatever they want about Asians, homosexuals, Mexicans, or white people. Calling me a redneck cracker and telling me I'm inbred, a meth addict, and live in a trailer park is no different from than what I said to him. But because I'm white, it gets labeled as racial. What people don't know about me is that I'm co-signed by gangsters from everywhere, all over the fucking country. I go to anywhere and I get respect because I keep my shit real and I bring it to your face. Would you rather a white person secretly talk shit about you behind your back? Or would you have them come out and just be like, yo, we're battling. This is battle rap. If you don't have, if you're not built for this, then what the fuck are you doing here? If you want to get sensitive and fucking be like, oh, you said something like racist, or you talked about my dead grandma. It's like, bro, we're entertainers, you know? And what I did entertained the fucking crowd. I did my job, and I'm going to sleep like a baby tonight.
It's 3.0. Interesting, because it's like battle rap is almost the only place you can get away with these things. Last question. You had mentioned something about your father saying, don't sleep with black women.
Sleep with black women, and if you're gay, I'll kill you.
Right. Did he actually say that?
Well, my father, he told me that, he said, if you come home and, you know, if you're gay, then I'm gonna, he dug a hole in the basement and woke me up at night, and he took me downstairs, and he showed me a grave that he had actually dug in the basement. We were having, like, contract.
Beyond the concrete?
No, well, we were having work done on the house at the time, and there was actually graves dug for my whole family.
Wow.
And he told me, he said, if you
come home. Would you ever date a black woman?
Well, I dated a Mexican Dominican when I was in college.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm multicultural, man, you know?
So your dad brought you to the hole in the basement, and he was like, son, this is where you're going if you bring home a black woman.
No, if you're gay.
If you're gay.
He said, don't ever date a black woman, and if you're gay, I'll kill you.
Okay.
Because he was actually, like, privy to some knowledge that a lot of people aren't. And that's that the LGBT movement is actually part of the Luciferian Illuminati agenda.
Okay.
That's what's happening with Caitlyn Jenner. Look, Tyga's now texting transsexuals. You heard about this?
No.
Yeah, it's out there, dude. And I'm saying, so like, homosexuality is trying to take over hip-hop and ruin it, man. I actually would be more in line with European Zionism, you know?
European Zionism.
I believe the white man destroyed America, and I think the white man should go home.
Okay.
Dead ass. We came to America and we ruined it, man. We killed all the Indians. We created slavery. It's time for the white man to get out of here. Go home. Marcus Garvey was doing it with the Black Star Cruise Lines. And I'm saying, dude,
let's
go home. Odin will see me in Valhalla. And today, brother, we feast at the table of the gods. And the nectar of the sunlight and the spirit is upon me, brother.
So, ladies, we were there witnessing the battle. And there were clearly a lot of, like, deep-rooted racial jabs. And it is battle rap. It is based on insult and leaving work at the door. You know what I mean? But how did you ladies feel? Because I saw you guys walk away. But how did you feel watching and witnessing what he was saying throughout the battle?
Well, again, like you said, you know, it is battle rap. So we do know that. We're both battle rappers. So we take that into account. But it is kind of offensive. But he did have some good points when he said that if he says racial things, then it's looked upon as worse. That's very true. So we got to give him credit on that. But, of course, being a black girl in the audience, we're like, God damn, did he just say that? So, you know, being a black woman, we're degraded, not just degraded by white people, our own men, our own people. So it kind of was very offensive. The only reason we didn't walk away because of him, I walked away to get her, but just keeping in account that this is battle rap, so don't let it get to you. The shit was crazy.
So do you think because it's battle rap, it's okay?
It's kind of hard not to if he says it's just battle rap, it's kind of hard not to think that he's not that type of person. So it basically let us know like what's in his mind.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? What type of person he is.
And what's your opinion?
I did feel very strongly on what it was said, because I feel very strongly on what's going on in the community in general in today's time, because we are going through a lot in the black community. But again, everyone can come into battle rap and speak their piece. And we say a lot, as he said, we can't put too much weight on his words, because we said the same things against many, many races and many forms of just ideals. So we can't think too much into his angle approach, because it was a very powerful angle. You see, we need to be interviewed about it. But no, it was not liked. No, it is not okay to have that mindset, because he did say a lot more about women than men, and he was battling a man.
Right.
So, but at the same time, he did get me, because I said something during his battle, and he started talking about whores, and I'm not one.
Right.
So I ran right into one of his bars. Mm-hmm. You'll see that on the footage, maybe. But on behalf of black queens, we should not be offended on him talking about hoes and bitches.
Because that's not us.
Women, period.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Bitches and hoes. Right.
Well, so at the end of the day, can we all get together in a shot? Like, would we have a drink together? Would we?
Can I come into the shot?
Yes, of course. Would we have a drink together at the end of the day?
Dude, ask about me, bro. That's what I say. Every interview I do, I'm like, yo, there's a reason why Mac Maul is on my record. You know what I'm saying? There's a reason why fucking everybody fucks with me. Because I'm thorough in the streets. And like, I swear, that's where real life happens. This is fucking battle rap. If you ain't got the skin for it, get the fuck on out of here, man. We're going to disrespect you. And I got nothing but respect for y'all on a personal level. Mm-hmm. So it is what it is. And I don't even expect nothing in return. Okay. I keep it 100 all day, every day.